Brava!
Yeah, applause to the orchestra as well. Bravo, that was very, very impressive. Do you have other movements ready?
No.
No, come on, play the second movement now. That's a real challenge. No. Wow, that was amazing. What a powerful piece of music. And I loved your cadenza. I can hear everything that we should hear. And I like the build up. I just love playing this piece after, you know, 5 minutes of cadenza, and then the tuba comes in and just drowns me. But it's just pretty powerful. Well, I don't really have much to say because I think you're extremely, pretty much almost perfect. one thing, I think Prokofiev himself is such a great pianist, so whatever he's written, play as he's written. Don't cheat. So this part, I saw you doing with right hand, which is awesome because I always miss my note if I do this. And that part, that risk challenging part, to take that risk, I think he wants you to hear the bum, bum, ba, ding, bum, bum. That's whatever his hand he's using that's written on the music. It has some musical meaning as well. So I want that to play with the left hand. And then I saw in the end, right before the cadenza, you played it with the left hand. And that's actually supposed to melt with the orchestra, so just with one hand. That's one thing, but you can change that in 1 second, I'm sure. And the other thing is I would have a little bit different take towards the end of the cadenza. I love the beginning build up until the G minor. And then when it goes to E minor, I would take the rhythm back a little bit, but more powerful. So instead of like almost the same tempo, I want to hear all the 32nd note. And that's probably gonna make it even more exciting. And then, you know, with the how it's like quarter notes in the G minor. Do you wanna show people here? Play the G minor part?
G minor.
Yeah. Yeah, play that part. Okay. And then play the part where it's E minor. So here, I think you could take down in terms of speed and make it more powerful. And then play 4 measures later. Play 4 measures later after that. Here. You don't have it memorized? So like, what I mean is here. See how it goes from like quarter notes to eighth notes and to 16ths. If you emphasize on that, it gives people like this even more build up. It's even more exciting. And here it becomes triplets and do not slow down. Whatever, you miss whatever note, it doesn't matter, but just have this rhythmic insistence until it goes all the way to here. That's my plan usually. And it just make it more interesting, I guess. The cadenza is amazing, except those things. But if you want to work on this, you really don't have other movements.
Not for today. I didn't work with my teacher.
Oh, well, you can work on yourself, no? why don't you from the beginning, maybe, I mean, I know it's you didn't even try the piano or anything. I liked it when you come back in the cadenza, but in the beginning, it could be, again, longer phrase. Try that again, from the beginning. You know what it is? is your hand constantly doing this? That's visually distracting to me. Maybe it's just a habit. For me, can I play? I haven't played this for a while. Well, it says narrate this thing is very important. So it is, it says narrative, like narrant. So it is a story he's trying to tell. By the way, the end, when tuba comes in after. That's the tuba or trombone, whatever, the brass out there. So in the beginning, dum, dum, that's the same. And then just know that constantly. Much more atmospheric. Because right now I hear dum. Which is very interesting because I never noticed that before. I like that, but more. Just some chaos. So, a few things when the orchestra, though, it's woodwinds. It's so creepy, right? It's like chromatics. And then, meanwhile, I'm trying to play something really tonal and beautiful, but you have to be aware of that, and together with the left hand. And then the thing is how, when with Prokofiev melodies, it always turns into a different key all of a sudden, right? So, and then C sharp, it's weird. And then I could, and more this. It's the only time the left hand has a line. And then the phrase is not ending. And then dee dee da 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 dum. And then the second time, it doesn't go there. It's like dee da. One step, half a step lower, and that I need to be more noticeable. And then way more crescendo. And then he finally found where he wants to go. So. How the first three notes is completely just derived out of all of this, right? So, never seen any music that's written coloroso, right? It's pretty colossal, monumental. Here is colossal. I don't even know what coloroso means. But with grand expression in mezzo forte. It was good, but I'll just, do you want to try or I might, okay. Thank you. feel better? Mm-hmm. You're like, no. I like your sound, but what bothers me still is the because you do this, I hear dum, bum, 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 rather than something like a string player, dee-da, dee-da. I lose the tension, but I like the sound of single notes. I lose that kind of, you know, the some kind of force, physical force, tension. And then I think that, da-dee-da, you know, goes to a B minor from a G minor. It's quite something, and I need kind of some outburst or release there, and then for two measures, and then back to like this kind of creepy, I don't know where I'm going kind of thing. Wait, let me play. I swear yours is better, but I just want to show you what I would do. Despite all the dissonance, it's a very classical composer. So you see all the instructions of how he would play. And over whatever his tempo is. And if you don't like his tempo, you tell me. You tell him. So you had a completely different tempo. And then I like your character, but it could be more sardonic. It could be more, it says with elegance. I think Prokofiev has the most vocabulary for piano literature. With elegance, but it's, you had it, but I would be more sarcastic about it. So, and this could be good. Play 60 notes, you have to be very precise. And this, you can have fun, you can do like... as you want, but just be very insistent in terms of rhythm, and then it'll be fine. But that was so beautiful. What do I say when they play so well? I don't know.
play the
second movement. Do you have any questions?
I don't know. Building the cadenza is such a hard...
Well, it is 5 minutes, yes.
It is a program. I think I want comments about building the tension for so long.
Building the tension for so long, I see. yeah. Well, you're doing it really well from in the beginning. and then, like I said, okay, the beginning is great, yeah? I actually liked it, this part and the, how you bring out the melody here. This is all fine. And then this part was, I heard lots of inner, like maybe just more mysterious. And same thing, you know, the B minor. So. Beginning is soft, but never lose the tension. And you did it really well. This is actually all fine. The only part, and then the second, the very first outburst, it was a. And what I have problem is this. You know, like the beginning, the pedal wasn't clear. So from here. I need much more drum.
Not ever retard here.
do you organize, you know, all the, besides the melody, how do you organize the sonority and what rest is doing? The, you know, the... Whew, okay. I have nothing else to say. The end is really beautiful. You can play it again.